Happy Monday, guys. Happy Monday, guys. Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. Just finished work today, guys. Super productive, actually, which I'm pretty happy about. I thought before I go out for dinner, guys, I'll do a quick video filming a comparison of two shoes that I bought recently, both in that sort of beautiful moc-toe type of design, a moccasin type of design. On the one hand, we have the beautiful Paraboot Michaels, and the second pair being the cousins to the Paraboot, these Kleman Padrors. Hopefully this video is of use to you guys. And yeah, please let me know if you have any questions or further questions in the comments. So from my understanding, guys, Paraboot were founded in 1908 in the Ezo region of France. The Paraboot Michael silhouette is the most classic and well-known silhouette, and apparently this was created in 1945. This particular colorway is the maroon or marron colorway, guys, excuse my French. Signature sort of Paraboot tag over here in green. That beautiful sort of moc-toe or moccasin style of design, guys. That U-shape kind of design. A real rugged sort of heavyweight type of sole. I picked these bad boys up in a size 42, guys. I'm usually a size 42 and a half with US 9.5 and Nikes, and these bad boys fit me pretty much perfectly. I reckon going probably half a size down is probably your best bet when it comes to sizing. Pricing. As you guys know, these aren't cheap at all. I ended up copying these bad boys for around 645 Australian dollars. Bit of damage done to the wallet. Moving on to the cousin of the Paraboot Michael, guys. These are the Kleman Padrors. These come in the Bordeaux colorway, guys. From my understanding, guys, Kleman as a brand was also founded or made in France around the same time that the Paraboot Michaels were created. It comes in a sort of classic moccasin or moc-toe type of design, a beautiful, again, U-shaped stitching. In terms of sizing, guys, I got these in a size 42, exact same size as the Paraboot. Pricing. These guys came at around 345 Australian dollars, nearly half the price of the Paraboot Michaels. In terms of silhouette, guys, the Kleman Padrors are pretty much a carbon copy. Very, very similar silhouette to the Paraboot Michaels. I think the tongue of the Kleman Padrors, guys, goes a bit more higher than the Paraboot Michaels, if you guys can see that, but I do feel that the tongue of the Padrors runs a bit higher than the Michaels. I guess that's something to keep in mind when you think about styling and where your pants sort of break or finish. Pretty much exactly the same sort of width-wise. Cool story, bro. That sort of three sort of stitching, paneling thing, whatever you call that, at the back of the shoe. Paraboots don't necessarily have that sort of same stitching at the back. From a comfort perspective, guys, I would say both shoes look and feel the same when on feet, in my opinion. Obviously, I haven't broken these in yet because I've just bought them, but I'll let you guys know and keep you updated in terms of how they're tracking. In terms of boxing experience, guys, I'd say not too much here for the Kleman's. Pretty simple kind of stuff, minimal. Paraboots is a bit more nicer, I guess. You get like a nice kind of Paraboot dust bag to put your shoes in. You also sort of get a nice care pamphlet or care package pamphlet you get when you buy Paraboots, guys. It kind of just teaches you how to look after the leather and all that too. So overall verdict, guys, I definitely would say if you're willing to pay the price and you have enough money in the bank, definitely recommend investing in a pair of Paraboots, guys. I think they're a timeless shoe, a timeless brand. They'll never go out of style. And I just think the quality is A1, guys. Definitely worth the price, definitely worth the investment for sure. But if you're not willing to have that sort of green Paraboot insignia in your shoe, then I definitely recommend checking out Kleman's, guys. The quality is pretty much exactly the same. The silhouette is the same, pretty much half the price, so.
Next minute.
Guys, happy Wednesday evening. Just about to go to dinner. And, I'm real excited actually because making my way to a place called Simulation Senpai, guys. I think it's a new kind of Japanese kind of sashimi concept place here in Sydney, and I can't wait. The photos look legit, so yeah, let's go. This is like Haymarket Chinatown, as I'm sure I've told you in other vlogs. Light rails, tram is right there, just straight up. Everything's here, bro. I think this place is about a 10 to 10 minute walk, so pretty much gonna be there and 10 minutes. Simulation Senpai, Darling Square, that's where we are, Darling Square. See where this place is, eh? Here we go. Simulation Senpai. Ordering this one, guys, the Wagyu urchin don. And just gonna pick it up now. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thanks. Oh, this looks insane. This looks insane, guys. This is the Wagyu beef sea urchin combo with rice underneath. Just Just finished that simulation, guys. Honestly, woof. Probably top 5 meals I've had in a long, long time, bro. Woo. It was like A5 Wagyu, the egg sauce, dipping sauce, the sea urchin. Woo. Woo.